All right, good evening. Welcome to the Boys Basketball and Cheerleading Awards. I'd like to thank you for coming out tonight. But we wanted to recognize a couple young men who received Academic All-Conference. And to me, Academic All-Conference, there's a GPA requirement, and it's for juniors and seniors. And this year we had two young men who made Academic All-Conference, so I'd like to call them up this time. Max Slusser. And Drew Sticker. We had one young man who was named to the Inc. Renews All-Area First Team. That was Ross Johnson. Ross also was named to the All-Conference Team. That's selected by the coaches from the other schools. Coach Rose cannot vote for his own players. So Ross was selected amongst all the other coaches as one of our All-Conference players this year. So congratulations.
All right, I'll go ahead and get things started off with the JV. It's not going to take very long at all, I promise. So what I'll do is I'm just going to call up the kids first, talk about the team as a whole. That's kind of how the season went, and then I'll get to the award. Okay, so I call your name, go ahead and come up. So I got Caden Atkins. Trent Krebs. Hunter McIntyre. Wright and Treach. Just to talk about these guys as a whole, one thing that I can say about this team is this was a totally unselfish team. There was never one guy out on the floor that was all about them. When I was looking at the statistics for the team, I think we had three or four guys that were averaging 5 points a game, and 5 points a game was actually our highest average. So we were pretty balanced. Again, we didn't have one person that wanted the ball in their hands all the time. These guys were played as a team. Everyone was always cheering for each other. I think about the Bremen game just comes to my mind there at the end of the season, how we battled back in that fourth quarter, and everybody busted off the bench at the end of that game. Even the guys that didn't really get to play, they're the first ones on the floor. And that's one thing that I love to see as a coach, just everyone cheering each other on. And again, everybody was totally on themselves. The season as a whole probably didn't go as well as some of the kids wanted. We ended up finishing 7-12, but we had three or four games that could have went either way. I think about the Winnemac game, the Freeman game, and the Bi-County. Even playing with Rochester and LaVille, those games came down in the fourth quarter. So easily could have been 10-9, 11-8. But one thing also about this team is these guys never stop fighting. I know early on in the season, we lost the first three or four games. And I told them as a coach, it's not easy to keep coming in after a loss and saying, hey, you guys battled, we just got to keep getting better. It was like a broken record. But these guys took to heart, came to practice every single day, kept battling, and it was amazing to see how much they improved from the beginning of the season to the end of the season. So thank you for that. That just shows all the hard work that you guys put in throughout the game. I'm going to go ahead and get to the awards. So, first award is our Hustle Award. And again, this is hard for me as a coach, but I felt like there are multiple kids that deserve this award. So we got together with the coaches and ultimately made the decision. But this year, the Hustle Award goes to John Gardner. Next award is the Most Improved Award. Again, this one was difficult as well because there were so many kids that from the beginning of the year to the end of the year improved a ton. But I think about this individual, started off the season kind of slow, but really picked it up towards the end of the season and ultimately ended up getting quite a bit of varsity playing time as well. So this year's Most Improved goes to Tyler Heckenbaum. Again, multiple kids could have received this one. This was the most challenging one for me to pick as a coach. But when I picked this individual, a few things came to mind. He was just a great leader for the younger kids. Was always helping them out in practice, helping them out in games. Maybe didn't get to play as much as he wanted to, but didn't complain one bit and took advantage of all the playing time he got when he got into the game. This year's been allowed to award goes to Chase Butler. Finish off here, okay? There's only one way that we can keep getting better, all right? And that is working in the offseason. What are two things that we can always work on in the offseason? Ball handling and shooting, all right? So the only way that we can get better is by putting in the work in the offseason. If you guys need anything, summer, right? I'll be more than welcome to come in and help you guys out and see you let me know. A few things also to finish, just some thank yous. Thank you to the parents. Thank you for all the team meals, stuff after the games. Thank you to all the coaches for letting me coach. And lastly, thank you to my wife for allowing me to coach because obviously I spend a lot of time away from her during the basketball season. So thank you very much.
Acknowledge a couple guys. Tyler, Trent, Chase, you know, even Keegan, John at times. Guys that didn't get enough quarters of letter varsity, but they practiced with the varsity pretty much all year. And you know, it's kind of a tough role for them because they have to practice a lot with the varsity players, and then you know, they're getting thrown back and forth. You know, they're with us, and the coach is going over JV stuff down there, and they're not with them. And so, you know, they're the type of players that I think is really important for the success of any team. You know, obviously, it's a tough role, but you know, with some hard work and dedication, I think these guys can really help us next year and be great leaders for us. The guys who did letter, start with the sophomores, Jared Hewitt. If not our hardest worker, he really puts in time and effort to work on his game, and that's why he kind of worked his way up to be a starter this year. He only averaged 1.54 points per game, but he was fourth in total rebounds, fourth in assists, third in offensive rebounds, third in charges taken, second in steals, and he did lead us in one category, personal fouls, with 63, but I think that just kind of shows how hard Jared works. I mean, Jared's a hard worker. You know, but he does foul a lot. I thought one of Jared's best games was the Bethany Christian game. He has a lot of improvements he needs to make in the offseason, but we're really excited about his potential and really looking forward to him being a great leader for us next year. Another sophomore, Quentin Thornburg. Like Jared, he's another one of our hardest workers. He too really puts in time and effort working on his game. Again, Quentin only averaged 2.14 points per game, but you know, he was fifth in total steals, second in three-pointers made. And of the five starters, he had the fewest turnovers and the fewest personal fouls. So he went from one extreme to the other there. Also Quentin led us in charges taken, which I feel you know kind of tells us a little bit about a player's toughness and grit. And you know, I thought Quentin really had a breakout game, showed his potential at South Central game in section. Tough for a sophomore to step up and do what he did in the first section that he played in. He had a really good game that game. And I think it shows what he's capable of doing. You know, just like Jared, you know, he has a lot of improvements he needs to make on the offseason, but we're really excited about his potential. Really looking forward to him being leading for us as well. Luke Richmond. Pleasant surprise getting Luke was this year. I thought Luke really got better throughout the season. You know, and he kind of battled the flu there right in the middle. It was like every time Luke would feel, man, Luke's really playing well in practice, and then all of a sudden he had the flu or something else happened. It seemed like he just had some setbacks this year. But you know, kind of like Jared Quinn, he only averaged about 1.3 points per game, but he was third field goal percentage and 63%. Second free throw rate, which is the ratio of foul shots per field goal attempt. So he basically gets the free throw line a lot, which is a good thing. He had the second fewest turnovers on the team. And you know, I thought Luke really played well against Winnemac, Caston, South Central, and Sectional. And with Luke, I think he's probably one of our most athletic, vocal players on the team. And because of that, I think we're really excited about what he's capable of as a leader. What his potential is for the future. You know, Luke said that he really felt like he gained confidence this year and got better as the season progressed, and we felt the same thing. So, you know, with a little more confidence and a little bit more improvement, we're really excited about what he can bring to us next year as a senior. Okay, next, junior Bo Hepler. We asked a lot of Bo this year. Not only did he have to handle the ball for us pretty much 100% of the time, we kind of asked him to score a lot more for us this year. And I think for the first part, you know, for a while, it took Bo a while to kind of adjust and balance those two things out. He put together a pretty solid season. I thought Bo played well, our team played well. He was third in steals with 26, third in charges taken, and surprisingly third in block shots. He was our second overall. Our stat program has an overall productivity thing on it. It kind of takes a bunch of factors into consideration, and it gives him a productivity rating. And that's kind of, you know, just based on a lot of different things. He was our second most productive player throughout the year. Our second leading scorer at 7.91 per game. Led us in assists with 39, led us in free throw percentage at 77%. And I thought one of Bo's most impressive games was when he shot 100% from the field when he fell in Trinity. And I thought that's when things started clicking a little bit for Bo and even for our team. And we really, you know, are excited about Bo for next year. And we really got to have him to be a good leader for us next year. Okay, the seniors. Max Slusher. Time as he probably would have liked, especially first half of the year, but he worked hard, never complained, accepted his role. He's an unselfish kid, and because of that, I thought Max really got better throughout the year. He started to get more playing time because those things didn't go unnoticed. He kind of showed what a type of player Max was with his stats. He was our second field goal percentage at 44.4%. He led us in three-point percentage at 37.5%. And he had the fewest turnovers on the team. And you think about that, that just shows how well Max accepted his role, did the things that we asked him, of him. And it's pretty amazing that he did that. I thought Max had the best games. I thought he played really well the first half against Elkhart Christian and Bremen. Max is a great kid. He had a good senior year. We're going to miss him there. Next senior, Drew Stick. Captains this year, so we expected a lot out of Drew and a lot of our senior captains. And I thought for the most part we got that from Drew. You look at his stats, he was kind of up there in about every stat we had. He was fourth leading scorer, fourth in steals with 18, third in assists, total rebounds, and charges taken. And I thought Drew, one of his best games was against Cassin, and he had three threes. He was just playing free, relaxed. I thought he played really well that year. Kind of like Max, Drew's a great kid, great leader. I had a great senior year, and we're going to miss him. Dylan Henson. No, Dylan's not here. But he was one of our team captains this year. Again, same thing, I expected a lot out of him. Much like Bo, I thought when Dylan played well, he played well. And this was evident in Dylan's stats. He was third in field goal percentage, third in free throw rate, which is getting to the free throw line. Third in overall productivity and our third leading scorer at 4.9 points per game. He was second in total rebounds at 3.3 rebounds per game, second in charges taken to 7, second 3-point percentage at 33.3, and led us to block shots. And I thought Dylan's best games, he played really well against Winnemac, Culver game, and the second time we played, like I said, I've been in Viscount. Mike, the other senior, Dylan's a great kid, had a good senior year. Okay, last senior, Ross Johnson. Mason gave out the awards for all area non-conference. Ross had a really good senior year. Ross is just a gym rat. He's one of our hardest workers. He's always in the gym. I think on the days we probably didn't have school and didn't play, Ross was at the Y playing on basketball. Obviously, his hard work and how hard he works and how much time he puts in shows up in his stats. He led us in pretty much every statistical category. He was third in 3-point percentage at 31.3, second in assists with 31, second in block shots, second in free throw percentage at 65. And then he led us in scoring at 17 points per game, rebounds 5.57 rebounds per game, field goal percentage at 55.2, steals with 32, free throw rate. And overall productivity, Ross's overall productivity average on the season was 18.0. The next closest was 3.59. So that shows how productive he was throughout the season. But Ross really busted out the South Bend Career Academy game where he had 30. That kind of set the tone for the rest of the year. Got the team some athletes. I didn't know why they were getting so excited, but I guess. His dad said if they get 30 points, they're taking the team to Applebee's. So our bench was, I think, more excited than Ross was. But I didn't know why they were cheering. But Ross had a great senior year. He greatly missed. To the seniors, I just want to say thank you. Your patience, most of these guys were players who had to wait patiently for their time to step up as seniors. And that's not always easy, and that's not always something that kids are willing to do. In our society we live in today, kids want things instantly. And, you know, I think in order to have a good program, you've got to be patient, you've got to work your way up, and, you know, figure out the fundamentals, figure out what we want done as coaches. And, you know, I thought these guys did a great job of that, you know, staying patient, you know, just kind of, you know, just putting in their time and effort and really working towards that. You know, thanks for the memories you guys have provided for the coaches, the school, and the community, the relationships established. All right, the season. First of all, you know, just what an unforgettable year. You know, Mason kind of alluded to that, all the cancellations due to weird weather, you know, losing our home court, just all the ups and downs a normal season has. I can honestly say that I've never been part of a season quite like this. You know, it was just, you know, it was difficult at times, you know, but at the same time, because of the kids, it wasn't as difficult as some may think. You know, we ended up with a record of 7-15, you know, but, you know, one interesting stat, we were 1-0 in home conference games. So, we didn't play many at home, but we were 1-0 in home conference games. We started off with a pretty rough stretch where we played OD from the Northwood, you know, kind of went through that. But I really thought right before Christmas break, we started playing better. Usually our call it our meeting where we sit down and have to clear the air. Usually that comes after Christmas with us. I think it came before Christmas. And I thought we really started playing better at that point. And then we lost our home court. And, you know, not to make excuses for our kids or our coaches or this team at all, but, you know, I'm not sure how big of an effect that has, to be honest with you. I think it might be bigger than what we realize, you know, because it really wasn't convenient. I was watching the film, and there was a game, you know, we just weren't rotating right on offense. You know, we would penetrate, our kids were standing, and, you know, I started thinking about it, and I thought, you know what, it's really not their fault, because we haven't worked on our rotation shooting drills that much, because, you know, when we're practicing the elephant venture with the JV, with that many kids, that it takes too much time to do that. And, you know, in the past, we're able to split up, maybe JV go to the elementary, we're in the high school by ourselves. So there are certain things that got taken away in the season that people don't realize, kids probably don't even realize, that I think probably affected us more than we even realized. But, you know, our kids, to their credit, you know, kept working hard, and that's all we can ask. You know, it was significant, you know, our practice before the section, I think it was Tuesday, and one of our younger coaches came in the gym, hasn't seen many of our practices, but, you know, he said the level of engagement at that practice, the way the kids were getting after it, communicating and talking, was amazing. I was shocked. I thought, you know, being 7 and whatever we were at that point, or 6 and whatever we were at that point, he thought, you know, kids would be done, ready to do that. That wasn't the case. You know, at the end of the year, they got stronger and the kids were working hard. And I think as coaches, that gave us, you know, a really good feeling towards the end of the year and heading into next year as well. You know, and that's, you know, again, that's all you can ask your kids to work hard. And it kind of shows in this next statistic, it just kind of stood out to me. Usually, at this point, I tell you, we outperform our opponents in almost every statistical category. That's not the case this year. Every statistical category, we got outperformed by our opponents. Most major categories: field goal percentage, 3-point percentage, turnovers, assists, rebound percentage, scoring, points per possession. We got beat by our opponents. That's why we hit the gates. But I thought this was really interesting. We had three categories where we did outperform our opponents: steals, charges taken, and second chance points. When you think about those, what those all have in common, they're all effort things. They're all things you can control. And so, you know, our kids, you can't say they didn't play hard. Our kids play hard, and, you know, I'm proud of that. You guys, Okay, now for the special awards. A lot of these are pretty cut and dry, they're pretty statistical based. So free throw percentage, this goes to shot really well. Last year, I don't think you shot as well. This year, you did a nice job. The free throw line shot 70.7%. That's pulled up. Next one's most rebounds. Again, pretty cut and dry. 117 total, 74 defensive and 43 offensive for a 5.57 rebound game average. And that goes to Ross Johnson. Most assists. This, I'm not going to tell you how many your average last year had last year, but he had 39 this year. And he had a 1.77 average. Alright. This next Mr. Defense. This was interesting. This was not a very clear-cut decision for me this year. Mainly because we played a lot of zone. You know, defense has a lot of different aspects, like on-ball defense, off-ball defense. Mostly grit, effort. To be honest with you, I could have given this to anybody. And I honestly couldn't decide on this. So I kind of looked at some of the defensive stats, such as charges taken, steals. And also, we asked these guys to guard the other team's best player on night number one. Because of this, I decided to go with Quinn Thornburg here. Okay, mental attitude. This award, I think, is one of the most important, most honorable we give. It goes to someone who is unselfish, coachable, mentally tough, buys into everything we do, accepts his role unconditionally, stays positive, and is a true leader on and off the court. When I started thinking of this award, one kid really stood out. And this kid is probably one of the best all-around kids that I've ever coached. No other way of putting this, it's your most valuable player to me. That's kind of the player you can't really part with most on your team. Some years, you know, like last year, I didn't think it was totally obvious who that one player was. I think, there's a lot of other aspects to the statistics, but based on statistics, I thought this was pretty obvious this year. He led in almost every category. He was voted in the Times Union All Area Team, as well as the unanimous All Conference selection. Okay, lastly, I just want to thank the players for their dedication, time, and effort. I know this wasn't the season we had hoped for, but like I said, I'm proud of these kids for their effort. I'm proud of them never quitting. The coaching staffs and their wives. I just thank you guys for your time, support, knowledge, scouting, your loyalty. I really appreciate what these guys do for the kids. They put in the same amount of time as me, but they don't always get credit. Coach Doug does a lot of things for not just me, but personally, but the program. I can't thank him enough. He's a pretty vital part of our program. I'm not always good at expressing that, but I really appreciate what these guys do. Blake coming in, being first year coach at the JV level. Okay, he worked hard, learned as he went. Did a great job as well. He does a lot for us. Blake does a lot of our scouting for us. Doug can't see the screen. He's too small. At least that's an excuse. I don't know if that's true. Actually, I can't see their numbers. So that's all on Blake. Brian Lindler, Larry Lindler for keeping our scorebook, Kempware, Wes Redinger stats. And that's a major job, administration, the parents. And I appreciate everything you guys have done. It's nice to have parents kind of get together and take care of the meals, the team meals. And that's always been a special thing, I think, at Triton. My parents do a great job of doing that. You know, and every year, you know, I say this every year, I think, but, you know, I think what's special about our kids and our parents is if you guys are complaining about things and are upset about things, and, you know, it's, I don't get any complaints. I mean, if you guys want to complain more, feel free. I mean, if you guys have to, but I don't hear it. I mean, I don't. It's been amazing how much support we've had from the parents throughout the years, you know, and I appreciate that. The cheerleaders for everything they do, the bus drivers, custodians, Don Bell for the House of Tennessee sticker for the work you guys do on game day, Ryan for everything you do for our webcast. You put in a ton of time and effort for that. It was amazing. Community for their support. And last but not least, my wife and daughters. It's basketball season is a long season. I always tell our kids that, you know, we probably spend more time together as a basketball team than you do with your family during that time. We're together for 4 months of the year, out of the year. So, you know, they put up with me when I'm gone all the time. When I'm home, I'm kind of mentally checked out at times just because of thinking about basketball, thinking about other things. So, you know, you guys, thanks for coming. I appreciate everything. Players, you know, did not get a schedule. Your younger guy, schedule. But thanks for coming.